This review is brought to you in part by Dean's Hobby Stop in Owosso, Michigan. Dean's has one of the Midwest's largest selections of used kits at great prices. They also feature new kits and supplies as well. Call Dean's to get their mail order list featuring hundreds of vintage kits, or check their website for great deals on both new and classic models.
Thanks for joining us at Right On Replicas, where we're proud to bring you the best scale model kit reviews on the planet. This review covers the re-release of the Streetle Beetle Custom VW. It's a 125 scale kit from AMT, number SCM031. It was first released as a kit number 205 back in the 70s and hadn't been produced until 2016. Now, it was produced by Round 2 and is available through the Auto World website while they last, or on the secondary and auction markets. Now, it's rated a skill level 2 for ages 10 and up for intermediate builders, requiring glue and paint. There's roughly 100 parts molded in white, chrome, clear red, and black vinyl. And this curb hopping curiosity sports a 40 Ford front end, baby moon wheels, and optional SS rims, along with custom bucket seats, a modified V-dub motor with dual carbs and megaphone headers. Now, the decals are water slide types, and they're very bright, and they are expanded from the original kit. And it includes a wacky wood grain door panel decal and some customizing graphics to make it shine. You get a fold-out instruction sheet with an exploded diagram of the typical AMT instructions for the time, and it'll be about 5 inches long, 3 inches wide, and 2.5 inches high when you're finished. Here are the contents of this kit. As you can see, it's got the one-piece body, and all of these separated components that need to be bagged individually have been done in that fashion. The tires are kept away from the glass, and also the chrome is separate, won't get scratched. Even the decals are wrapped in cellophane. Now, we're going to be using mostly Model Master cement, the liquid type, for most of this. Sometimes super glue for strength, or white glue or crystal clear for the window glass. But always remember to heed the manufacturer's safety and use guidelines when using any of the products seen or heard mentioned in the review. As you'd expect from a wild custom, all of the engine parts are completely chromed, and you'll need to remember to scrape off any plating before you join parts together with adhesives, because they will not stick to chrome plating very well. So keep that in mind as you're building. And then go ahead and assemble the heads and the block, and once those are set and dried, you can build off of that and assemble the rest of the engine parts that we had shown earlier to the motor. Now you can choose your tires. They have some regular white walls or black walls, depending on which way you turn them in or out. If you want to get crazy, you could use white walls on your custom. But go ahead and pick your rims, as you get a choice between the two styles. Then assemble the rim front and back into the tires as required. Using a little medium setting super glue should keep them in place. And now go ahead and locate all of the chassis parts and seats from the kit, and gather them together as you see here, and paint them flat black, just a regular rattle can, or you can decant or use some Model Master paint in your airbrush. Go ahead and paint those flat black. Although the construction is a little spindly here and some of the parts are fragile, they're pretty easy to assemble because they're mostly one piece units, and I would use some super glue for strength here. Now, assemble the front suspension then to the chassis, and then the engine to the chassis and rear suspension as well. Then add the seats and the fuel tank, and install the pedals and the shifter in the tub. Now grab the tires that we had assembled earlier, and since those are dry, you can put a little dab of glue, super glue, on the ends of the axles and the front spindles, and put the rears and fronts into place. Remember, of course, they're different between the front and the back. Now we're going to prep the body for paint. Remove any of the flash that's around the wheel wells, etc., and parting lines, although they're pretty minimal on this unit, but there will be some slight ones. And we're going to add the engine cover in place by taping it into position. Then I'll wet sand the body all overall with a fine grit sandpaper, about a 600 to 1000, and get rid of any blemishes you might find. And then primer the body and wet sand it again. If you do see some blemishes you missed the first time, go back over those and then give it another coat of primer and let that dry prior to paint. My little bug looked like it needed to be green. I thought that the decals would complement the color. And this is Tamiya Metallic Green Pearl, which I thought was a nice color for a bug. And of course you can use just about any color. The decals pretty much will go with almost everything. Maybe stay away from black or dark blues, but start with some mist coats, real light ones, and then go ahead and add wet coats, two or three, until you get a nice clean and smooth finish, and paint the body inside and out to let it dry. Well, now you can decal the body. And they're large. I suggest using some of the decal setting solutions for these so that they fit the contours and in the crevices of the panel lines. And then go ahead and grab the chrome parts, the grille and the headlight and the bezels, etc., and get those ready for installation. Glue the headlight bezels and the grille into place, and remember to scrape off any chrome plating or paint that's in the area of your joint. And also the taillight bezels. Then go ahead and use some white glue or crystal clear to add the headlights lenses and the taillight to the bezels back there. Now we're going to continue by adding the window glass to the interior tub by turning it over, and again use some white glue or crystal clear for that installation. Now we can detail the dash. The interior of the car was black, so I left it that way, but you can detail it in body color if you like, or even an offset color. And of course the wheel has chrome spokes, but you could use a black or a wood grain for the rim. Anyway, put the wheel together and then add the column to the floorboard and install the body to the chassis. Next, you can glue the hood into place onto the body. Now you can leave that tape in the top position that you used to put the motor cover on while you were painting it for a hinge, or just take it off. The engine cover just fits in there and it'll stay there for shelf display with that wild looking spare tire bump. But that's it. We're finished. And this great looking little custom is just that. It's not a contest car, but it sure is cute. And you can do some pretty wild customizing with it. Obviously, there's other things you could do. You could even try putting a motor into the front and see how that works out. But there are a number of options. You could wire the engine, etc. And the detailing for the grill could be, you could black that out. And just to make it a really standout looking custom. But there's also, you know, a lot of aftermarket things for Volkswagen. So don't forget those too. And if I were you, I'd buy one and put it on my shelf. Thanks for joining us at Right On Replicas, where we bring you the best scale model kit reviews on the planet. And so that you don't miss any more, please subscribe to our YouTube channel, or you can find us on Facebook or at our website, rightonreplicas.com. Thanks.